It is May 5th, Cinco de Mayo. So far, so good. I have, let's see, today is the 5th, and I started these on April 15th. I'll set them outside in the ground in about 7 to 10 days. And I should have close to the 20 plants I need. They're looking good so far. I'm getting leaves, my first real leaves growing on them. I still have little sprouts coming up. There's one right there. It took 2 or 3 days for the heat to work up from the heat mat through the trays and get into the pots. So I need to start them 2 or 3 days earlier next time. This is the first time I've used a heat mat to get consistent germination. Things are looking good. Looks like I'm going to have at least close to the 20 plants I want. I have the loofa plants outside ready to plant. Finished getting my garden tilled up yesterday. Today's the 16th of May. It's a pretty day. I wanted to take a minute and just talk about my fertilizers I'm using. This is a liquid 511 organic listed. And this is a general purpose organic listed 356. I think between the two I can feed my plants a fairly well balanced diet. When I plant them, I'm going to put the solid general purpose fertilizer in the hole, put the plants in, and then fertilize with some of this liquid stuff on top, which really works out well because I want more nitrogen early on, and then later on I want to get more potash and phosphorus to encourage blooming and bud formation. I have two plants here I'm going to transplant into the earth. One hole dug there, another one dug there. I'm going to throw a little over a tablespoon of just general purpose organic fertilizer in them. Then I'm going to separate these two plants, put one in each spot, and water them with some of my liquid fertilizer. Today is June 7th. The plants are starting to vine. It's time for me to get stakes in the ground and strings attached so they have something to climb on. Here is a volunteer vine that I transplanted from the garden to the fence. Last fall, I threw out several loofah pods that weren't fully matured, and I have little plants sprouting all over my garden this year. Here's another volunteer vine that came up over here by my pepper plants. Simply planting a loofah pod in the fall is a viable way to start these things. Today is the 17th of June. I have all my strings and stakes put in. Still need to add some more plastic, do some hoeing. These are probably my biggest plants right now, about 3 feet tall maybe. This is the volunteer plant I got out of the garden and planted along the fence. It's about 2+ feet long, I'd say. Today is July 4th. The loofah vines have really taken off. I have one that's all the way to the top of my trellis here. Quite a few that are more than 6 feet long. That one's about 8 going up the trellis. They're climbing nicely. I've had a few buds and blooms already. Here's one down here low. And of course the morning glories are trying to get into them. I ran out of plastic, sort of, and planted pumpkins for ground cover down here, hoping they'd keep the weeds down. I don't know if they've achieved their goal, but they're certainly growing. Here's a nice looking little one. Things moving along well. I like that blend of organic fertilizers I used. I haven't added anything else to it yet. So far, so good. Here is the, one of the volunteer vines I pulled out of the garden. It's reached the top of the chain link fence and it's starting to grow down the top rail. Today is August 8th. Here's a nice flower. It's a female flower. Getting pollinated by the big bee. This, of course, is my fence. And let's see, here's a male flower, cluster of males. And here's a few more males on top. Oh, there was a bee in that one. I disturbed him. And here's a nice, there's a male flower. And we've got a nice little fruit forming here. Start of a loofah sponge. Right now it's just slightly larger than edible size. It's growing. A few morning glory vines sneaking in here. The leaves are a little pale looking. I don't know if that's from types of fertilizers, or they may need more fertilizer. Some of my volunteer vines that I let grow out in my garden are starting to produce, but they're just laying on the ground. Here's a pod growing on a volunteer vine that sprouted in my garden. Over here beside it is a small cantaloupe. It's September 15th. My garden helper, Yeti the cat, is out here. I have quite a few blooms today. I fertilized these about 2 weeks ago. They were looking kind of pale. They're doing a little better. Cicadas are out. I haven't really seen or heard that many cicadas this year. They were really loud down in the valleys, not so much up here on the hill. I have lots of little loofahs growing. Here's one of our friendly local pollinators. There he goes. There it goes. I'm being attacked here by a yeti. The vines have done really well this year. I haven't had as many flowers as I would like to have seen. And I don't know how many loofahs I'm going to end up with. There's a few hanging out here. Let's see, there's one. And here's another one. I have several, they're hiding in there. So I don't know how well my organic fertilizers have worked as far as providing flowers. I've grown some good vines. Apparently they could have used a little more potash and phosphate, maybe earlier, a little earlier in the season to get more flowers. So like usual, it's going to be a race against the frost. There's a loofah in there. Got some down here on the fence. They're looking pretty good. Another one of my pollinating friends. Digby. Here's a nice looking loofah. Loofah pod. Growing back here on the fence. These ones on my fence seem to do a little better. They have more space to spread out. My trellis is pretty crowded this year. But as we go down the vine, there are some small little pods, some little clusters of flowers, some insect damage. But overall, fairly healthy vines. Today is October 20th. I've been picking a few of the loofah pods. Here's one that's about ready to be picked. Some nice white fiber in there. September was very dry and I've had some really nice pretty loofah pods. Good fiber. Here's my assistant Yeti. So I've peeled several already. So far we've avoided getting any frost here. I need a couple more weeks to really get a good yield out of these. Yeah, he's gonna help me out. Mr. Crow's out this morning too. Here are some of the loofahs I've picked already. That dry September air gave us some really nice light colored ones. Let's see what else I have here in my sack. This one here is pretty good. And what else is in here? This is a pretty one. The dry fall weather makes for really nice light colored ones without a lot of spots. You have to water them. I had to water these quite a bit. Like I said, if I'd fertilized them a little bit sooner, I did fertilize them in August, but I would have had a few more by now. A lot of things were going on in my life at that point, and afraid my garden got a little bit neglected. Now here's a little brown one that it was laying on the ground. It turned really dark brown before I spotted it. It was starting to rot, so it's good to catch them early while you can. So that's what I got so far. November 2nd. Frost expected. As usual, I have plenty of green loofah pods hanging on the vines. This is a really nice large one. That's a big and big thick one. And lots of others of all sizes and a few odd shapes. This one here, it needs to be peeled. Usually peel them before they get it this far along. See if I can get some of that skin off. Oh yeah. Looks nice in there. And I'll get that one off and get it peeled. The rest of them, if they survive tonight, they'll almost certainly get frozen here in the next few days. At which point I'll just have to pull them all off and start breaking them open and see what I have. It's November 9th. Here's a few loofahs I've peeled the last couple days. I still have quite a few to get. I'm going to use scissors to cut the stems. And carry them all off in a bucket. It's a really nice big one. I hope there's good fiber in that. Big tough one. I have a bucket full here to peel. I just do a few at a time, especially these big tough ones. I'm going to try to crush the outer skin with my foot. See if I can get it to break. I don't know if this is going to be good or not. Smash it and hit it a few times, see if I can bust some of that skin off. It did break some of it loose. Maybe this one won't be too hard to peel. The fiber is, it's not 100% mature. There's a lot of sap off to wash out, and I'll see what I end up with. Here's what it looks like peeled. Skin came off fairly easily. And you should always wear gloves when you do that. These things will exfoliate the skin right off your hands. There's a little foamy stuff here at the top. So it's not fully formed. This could have used another week or 2 weeks. It's nice and large. I'm sure it's useful for something. But I have a lot of rinsing to do to get the sap out of it. A lot of sap. Of course, the seeds are white. They're not matured. There's some good fiber there, though. It is November 10. I'm drying some more loofahs out here in the sun. It's quite a mixed batch this year. It's winter time now. The loofahs have all been picked, peeled, cleaned, and most of them sold. I have seeds for sale on my website. I planted about a dozen, about 12 garlic cloves in October, and that'll give me something to watch over the winter. Thanks for watching.